Calling all young scientists pre-K through 7th grade. You won't want to miss a minute of this year's in-person Sciences Everywhere summer camps at the National Museum of Nuclear Science and History. I spoke with Nuclear Museum Deputy Director Jennifer Hayden to get all the details on all the fun that they have planned. Joining us this morning, we have Jennifer Hayden. She's with the National Museum of Nuclear Science and History. Good morning, Jennifer.
Good morning.
I love when we have you on. You always have something fun to show us.
We do. I'm working with eggs and water today.
Perfect. Right before Easter. I love it. Okay, before we get to that, though, let's talk about Sciences Everywhere summer camps because they are back.
They are. We're having in-person science camps, and those are for kiddos pre-K through 7th grade. These camps are so cool. It's everything from zombies to Minecraft to Ewoks and Chewbaccas or Wookiees. I mean, there is truly something for everybody in these camps. I'm very excited about them. My two little boys are dying to come to these. But again, it's for all kiddos of all ages up to 7th grade. But we also have a counselor and training program for the older kids. For 14 to 17, we have a training leadership program going on this summer too.
Oh, that sounds like so much fun. I love it. Great. Okay, so I know you have so many different themes that you kind of just covered there. I know they're on your website, so we're going to give that to our viewers in a second. But I want to get to that interesting experiment you have going on today.
Yes. Okay. So this one must have parental supervision because we are dealing with fire. So what I'm going to do is I have an egg. This is not boiled. It's a raw egg, but you can use boiled. It doesn't matter. And I'm going to burn the outside of it to create a layer of soot. So by burning it, it's going to become black. And that is going to have a layer of soot that sits on top of the layer of shell. And then I'm going to dunk it in water to make a silver egg. It's a visual effect that takes place. It took me a while to actually burn one of the eggs, so I did that earlier, but I'm going to show you. All you have to do is actually just hold the flame, again, parental supervision. When you hold the flame up to an egg at a certain point, it starts turning it black. So you want to take the time and actually make the entire egg as black as possible with the flame. So again, that's why this the parental supervision. And this did, for some reason, it just takes me forever. And I think my lighters aren't very good either. So you're going to work around your entire egg, trying not to touch it too much to get it as black as possible.
And then I'm just going to... Right?
Exactly. Oh, see, woo, it just happened. And I'm going to dip it in some water, just regular tap water, nothing cold or hot. And once that goes inside, it makes the visual effect that it's actually turning silver because the water goes between the layer of soot and the layer of eggshell. And as it's going around, it just makes it look like it's silver.
Interesting.
Yeah. I mean, it just takes a long time to make it black. So
I was thinking a pretty simple project, but definitely you need patience.
You do, very much so. And then someone to make sure everything's working well for you. Yeah.
So true. Okay. So I love all these experiences you guys bring because that's what you guys do for all these summer camps and that we just mentioned earlier. So give me the ages again if parents missed it.
So these are pre-K through 7th grade. They are week-long themed camps. So it's all day long, and we do have free before care and after care. So we can have your kiddos pretty much all day long in a safe, fun environment. Also, still social distancing, masks are required. But so many great camps this summer. It's going to be amazing, June 1st through August 6th.
How do people register, and is there a cost?
There is a cost. So the weeks are, if they are 5-day weeks, which are the majority, then it's one cost. And then 4-day weeks, such as over the 4th of July weekend, it's a little bit different. All of those are online at nuclearmuseum.org, and that's how you register too.
Perfect. Jennifer Hayden, once again, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.